टाइम मैनेजमेंट इज अ स्किल, इज एन आर्ट एंड इट्स अ सेल्फ डिसिप्लिन प्रिंसिपल. वन कैन मैनेज द इवेंट्स विथ रिलेशन टू टाइम बट कैनॉट मैनेज टाइम. So in this video, we are going to talk about the effective ways of how you can become a time management, which comes after a prolonged dedicated practice and a rigorous follow-up with utmost dedication. Guys, welcome back to my channel Siddharth World, and you're watching Time Series, and this is Siddharth and welcoming you all to the top 10 strategies for time management and effective ways of learning it, how you can implement, how you can get it productive, and how you can be beneficial out of it. If you find any value in the video, please do press the like button, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do subscribe to the channel and do press the bell icon so that you never miss an update. Top 10 strategies for time management and how better way you can become a time management person. So time management greatly and solely comes within the capability of an individual with the following four steps, which is self-analysis, planning, evaluation, and self-control. Imagine that we have a limited time to finish down our activities. So what we aspire or what we admire to do is to focus on the activities or the events with relation to time, rather than focusing that we have a limited time to finish down our activities. So what we aspire or what we admire to do is to focus on the activities or the events with relation to time, rather than focusing on controlling time, because two activities at the same time, which means at any given point of time you should be only focusing on one particular activity. Know how you spend your time means evaluate or analyze where most of your times are being spent. How you are spending your time? Is most of your time is spent on job? Is most of your time spent on personal activity? Is your time spent with family, or is it how? Why this is? Because you need to know where you are spending how much time and how you have to plan the activity. Remember the first thing, which will give you the better insight into it. So you will have to plan out your activity. Now imagine you are doing that's basically because in the next step, which is your planning, you will be benefited from it. You will be able to understand after you analyze. The next step is planning. So you are planning now your activity. Now you know important thing, set priorities. What do you mean by priorities? Now in the first step, you have analyzed where your most of the times are being spent. Are you productively spending the time or not? Now it's time for the planning stage or prioritizing the task. Which are the tasks which are most important? Prioritize, less prioritize. Planning tool. Let's say you cannot prioritize the things, or you cannot do. Easier to plan. Easier to plan is like, for example, let me give you a perspective. Like, for example, every one of us has got a smartphone. All you can do is you can click the calendar option or to-do list option that is there always in your phone. I'll give a different, all medium critical tasks will give a different color. So with that, what happens is every activity is identified separately and gives you a pop-up which one to focus how much. And after every activity, make sure you note down what you did in that activity and how much time you utilize. Say the fourth strategy, get organized. Always remember, get organized in such a way that you get the planned activity only once. You are not putting the activity here also, there also, there also, not. You have to have a strategy to implement in a system that allows to get the activity to handle information once. So which means once you plan the activity, it's planned. Schedule your time appropriately. Schedule your time appropriately means block your time for your high priority activity and make sure that particular time frame which is being set for that high priority task is not disturbed, because that is more priority to you. If your friend or colleague or anybody is calling, make it very clear that, sorry, that's a high priority task for me, I have to give priority to it, I have to finish that and then I can join it. Get help from others. What does that mean? Delegate. When you realize a particular activity is not compatible with you, or you are not able to get that activity done, get it outsourced from the correct person, whether it is your friend, family, relative or your colleagues, anybody who has got the skill. Never stuck up with a task that you are not able to complete and or you don't have the expertise to complete. Get it delivered by others. Eight. Manage external time wasters. What do I mean by external time waster? External time wasters is like distraction because of cell phone, distraction because of your other things. And distraction through social media and everything. So manage external time wasters has been categorized into different sectors. Let me give you a brief. You have got telephone calls, unexpected visitors, emails and chats and family obligations. So what do? The easiest thing is when you fix a time frame, avoid multitasking. You lose time when you're switching between one task to another. So the ideal principle for any time management learner or any time management professional is to remember the golden principle of doing one activity at a time to be healthy, to stay healthy. Now, what does that mean? That means that whatever activity you plan, whatever exercises you plan, however you plan, if you are not healthy, if you are not living a healthy lifestyle, you will definitely face the issue.